Hello, friends. Welcome to Melissa's Musings. I am so excited to be here with you guys. As a few of you join on in, happy Monday. The sun is back to being beautiful and shining in San Diego, and I could not be more happy. I love when my house is like warmer than 75 degrees all the time. I can't get enough. Hi, Paul. Long time no talk to you. Thanks for joining in to Melissa's Musing. So, what's been coming up for me lately is conservation of my time and being like super, I thought I had something in my teeth. I was like, do I have something in my teeth right now? Super conscious of my time. Hey guys, thanks for joining in. Hey Nin, hi Ollie, hi Anna. Oh, thanks for all the hearts, the love. Hi Paul. Oh, I miss you guys. So, yeah, really powerful lessons for me. And this is something that like continually comes up. Like for those of you who have continually watched my musings, who know me, who love me, you know that this is one of my biggest struggles, and it is saying yes to myself and no to other people. I am constantly, I've realized, in this state of FOMO, a fear of missing out. And I've been able to identify that this is actually like a fear within myself. It's not like, oh, I have FOMO, like hashtag FOMO. Like, no, I actually, I think, have a fear of missing out where I get this like sick feeling in the pit of my stomach if I'm missing things. So, and I've had a conversation for a really long time now, for about probably since I got sick, 4 or 5 years, around missing out of things on things because of my stomach, because of my health issues. I'll feel like I'm missing out on things. Like I'd rather be there than in my bed, right? So I'm not present to where I'm at, which is in my bed or resting, but instead I'm living in a place that doesn't exist, in a fear of missing out, and in a state of disappointment over not being able to do something because of my physical circumstance, right? Do you see where I'm going with this? And so what's been really powerful for me over the last 2 weeks, let me go down my story pathway for a little bit. So March has been a tough month for me on a personal level. I'm going to get vulnerable with you guys. March has been tough for Melissa Steele. I had a really good friend's bachelorette party at the beginning of this month that I was super committed to going to and I wanted to go to. And 3 days beforehand, I got so sick with this terrible flu. And in hindsight, the answer would have been to skip the bachelorette party, but I wanted to go so bad, and I consistently have a fear of missing out, and I was so afraid that all of these girls were gonna have such a great time without me that I went and I sacrificed myself and I said no to myself and the fact that I probably should have stayed in bed, and I said yes to my friends. And so I went to this bachelorette party, and in hindsight, I should have said no. So, long story short, those of you who watch my musings, you know how this story goes. Got super duper sick at the bachelor party. Ended up having to literally switch my flight to fly back earlier on Sunday, and I missed the bridal shower. And I came home wickedly ill, like so sick. Got into the car when John picked me up from the airport and just hysterical started crying, because for those of you guys who don't like to travel, like me, and who just like travel in general, feeling shitty when you travel is quite literally, I think, one of the worst things on the planet, because you are in a space this big on the airplane. If you have a fever and chills, you just feel like death. I was hacking, I was coughing, I had a fever, I had a stomach ache. Like, I just felt like shiitake. I got into the car when John picked me up and I just was like, oh my God, I can't believe you're here. Oh my God, I can't believe you're here. And I just like, and John was like, oh babe, you're home. Relax. But clearly had pushed myself beyond what I was capable of. And so then what ended up happening next was, got back into the swing of things with work and did not take care of myself as much as I should have, and really just have been in constant practice and learning this week. Hi, John. John just got back into the car. He was running an errand. Are we embarking? Are we leaving?
Can I?
I don't know. I might lose you guys.
I can wait for you.
Yeah, can you wait for me? Thanks. So I'm just going to finish my musing. I want to finish my thought before I lose you guys. So ultimately, have been reminded over and over again, so many times this month, about like prioritizing myself and being taught a very quick lesson each time I'm not. So each time I'm given the opportunity to choose myself And, like, I'll have a conversation of, okay, I feel like I really get to rest today, but you know what? I feel like I really want to do this. I think I can do both and create a win-win. I'm going to go, and then I'll take a nap when I get home. Well, I go, and then I'll end up feeling so sick because the universe is trying to teach me a lesson that by the time I get home, I feel so ill that I don't even want to rest. Like, I'm like, oh my goodness, this is just terrible. So, it has been that, and John's in the space now, but my awesome husband for constantly being in a space of like, you get to rest, I am here to cover you, the team is here to cover you, like, take a step back. So the powerful realizations really started coming in the last like 2 weeks, and it was a really triggering moment for me when I was talking to somebody recently and they told me that they were sick for 6 years and they were in bed for 6 years. And like right away, all of the insecurities and the judgments that I have around my sickness came up for me in like a split second, because I literally thought to myself, oh my God, like I would feel so useless if I was in bed for 6 years. Like immediately, even though I hadn't been the one to be in bed for 6 years, I felt so unworthy. Like in a split second, I immediately went to the place of like, if you were in bed for 6 years, you'd be a piece of shit. Because that's what the inner conversation that I have tells me, that my worthiness is totally linked to my production, and a lack of production equals piece of shitness. Like, that's the way that my mind works. That's my ego conversation. I know that all of you have evil ego conversations that somehow run your lives, and mine is with time. Mine is with, you know, that fear of missing out, that constant reminder of not having enough of it, and the constant battle for me of not having the energy to feel like I had to do the things that I want to do. So what has been really powerful for me in this last week and the changes that I've made, I'm declaring them here and now. I've said no to 4 weddings this week, all of which would have been really awesome to attend to, or really in like the last 2 weeks, but all of which would have been awesome to attend, all of which are like so fun, that have tons of our friends going. The people whose weddings they are, one of them's even family, like, they obviously mean so much to us. But I look back on my year last year at stretching myself so thin to attend 12 weddings, and I don't want to do that to myself this year. I've learned from that, right? So that's the space I'm in. I've had over a dozen friends reach out in the last week wanting to get together with me and to have tea or lunch or whatever it looks like, and I so badly want to get lunch and tea with them. Believe me, when I am turning you, if you are one of the people that I have turned down this week, know that it has been incredibly painful for me to turn you down, and it has been a learning process for me, because my fear of missing out and my yearning for connection, my yearning to want to be with my friends, to want to hang out with my friends, to enjoy that time with people, I get to be really cognizant of like how that's been affecting me though, because of course I want to do these things. I love all of my friends, and I also get to be really cognizant of my space and my healing. So right now I'm on a very healing journey. My Melissa's Musings has certainly taken back burner, which is 100% okay. A lot of my work and proactivity has taken back burner. I've literally not dropped one ball for any clients, which is amazing. John and I have been able to beautifully upkeep everything, and John has been such a champ. Shout out to amazing John Steele. And so no client has suffered any effect of me taking a step back. Zero. We have an amazing team in place. And, like, no friends have been like, oh, you bitch. I can't believe you. Like, no. They understand that right now I really get to focus on me, that right now I get to prioritize me and my health. And just because all of the proactive things that are sitting on my to-do list, my like 40 things that I could be doing to like further advance the business or further advance my personal learning or whatever it looks like, all of that can wait. And it's totally okay with waiting. Yes, we all love John. Everybody give John a little shout out, John. Everybody's saying we love John Steele. That's right. I love him too. So I hope that was meaningful to you guys. Know that you can say no so that you can tell yourself yes. I've been creating so much space for myself to just like lay in bed and literally do nothing, and it's been glorious because I feel like I'm burnt out on such a core level. My poor body's like, I need to get rid of this cold. And so that's where I'm at, and it's been an awesome experience, and I'm learning so much, and I'm really enjoying with where I'm at, and I'm learning that like I've really just been learning to breathe through my moments of discomfort And, like, sometimes they're moments, sometimes they're days. Like, the past few days, I've been having a really rough stomach week. And I'm just like, I guess this episode's a week. I guess it's not moments. I guess it's not hours. I guess it's more than days. This time it's a week. So, it is what it is. It's a better day tomorrow, always. I love you guys. I'll talk to you soon. Thanks for watching. Hi, peeps. Thanks so much for all of you for tuning in and for staying with me the whole time. I love you guys. I'll talk to you soon.